Krásny deň prajem všetkým hádzanárskym priaznivcom a fanúšikom. Naše hádzanárky čaká prvá akcia v novej sezóne. Na novembrovú prvú fázu kvalifikácie, v ktorej nás čakajú lobišky, sa budú pripravovať v Michalovciach, kde následne odohrajú prvý z dvoch priateľských zápasov proti Ukrajinkám, druhý potom o deň neskôr vo Vranove na Toplov. Pred odchodom na východ republiky sa v našom štúdiu Slovenského zväzu hádzanej zastavil aj reprezentačný kormidelník Jorge Dueñas. Jorge, welcome.
Dobrý.
An easy question to begin with. What did you do during summer? I saw that you also visited the Youth World Championship tournament.
Yes, during this summer I worked a lot of with the handball because first I went to the junior championship to analyze the championship, working with the IHF Federation at the same time helping and supporting the Latino of Slovakia, and I have the opportunity to watch our players during this championship. My opinion was very good. And then I went to the IHF Games in Azcamistrita to watch the games of Precadets teams. Mm-hmm. And then I went to Macedonia to watch the games of the Jobs team. So now I have more information about our players.
Yes. How would you rate of our participation in the tournament? Has anything surprised you?
Okay, but first I think that the junior team, my opinion, have had a good performance during the tournament. They have a very tough the group, but in general, I think that they play good level. One of the most important players, Barbara Lant, was injured, so I think that no participation of this player was very difficult for the team because during the last years this team played with this right back player. So, but in general, I think that this team playing with very good level. For me, it was very good to watch some of the young players playing an important championship because I think this player in the future we play with the other team. So in this team, I think that we have a very, very a lot of players to play the other team in the future. So I think that it's this championship was very good for them. And then the rest of the teams and the Jot team and the Precades team, I think that it was a very good chance to play international matches with level. Mm-hmm.
There were several changes in the nomination roster of the upcoming camp. Several players are returning, including goalkeeper Oguntoye, Pastorková, Sarková, Habanková and Barbara Lantz. It's great news. It is good news.
Yes, good news because in the Lance camps last season, we have a problem with this play because they were injuries. So now they are recovered. So it's a good news for us. And I think that they are playing in good level. So I think that we will play with a good level during the next matches, the friendly matches and the qualification for the World Championship.
Mm-hmm. There was an upsetting message in recent days. One of the key defense players, Emma Hudáková, got injured. She will be replaced by Natalia Nemetová, who is currently in good form and is also a decent defender. Do you see the situation in this way?
Yes, you know that the injuries are not good for the team, but in this case, Emma, in the last match, she had a problem with the knee and with the and she decided to to leave the team during this this camp because she needs to recover for the future. I think that it's good news because the most important thing is the health of the player. So we changed by Italia Nemetova. She is very important player for me for the future, but during the last time, in the last year, she had a lot of injuries, but now she's training and she's playing in good level. So for us, it's good news.
Yes, the roster also does not include experienced goalkeeper Adriana Medvedeva and great back Mariana Rebičová. What is the reason of their absence?
This player, they decide to leave the national team. I think that they thought about the time in the national team was finished. So I think that it's a particular decision. So I have to respect. I think that they have level to stay in the national team, but. The most important thing is if the player has good ideas to continue with the national team. If they decide to leave the national team, I have to respect and we have to change with young players for the future.
Mm-hmm. Will they be missed?
Experienced player, the first thing, no? Because Adriana. Mari played during a long time in the national team and they have a big experience. But this is the life. The teams have to change, and this is the moment to change to thinking about the future.
Mm-hmm. There are also some younger players getting chance to show what they can do, such as Štípová, Dvorčáková or Dmitrenko. These are talents who are currently one of the core players in their teams. How important is it for them to get minutes in important matches?
Yes, in the question before you asked about the participation in the Junior Champions League, this player played very well in the Junior Champions League during this summer. And I think that they have level to play with the other team, so it's a chance to play important matches during the next camps. So, and at the same time, for me, it's important the rest of the players, of the young players, maybe they have chance to play with the national team in the future. Yeah? This player with 19 years old or 20 years old, they reach the level of the national team, and now this is a mirror for the rest of the player to watch the possibility to reach the national team in these times.
Mm-hmm. In the new season of MOL League, these players already played through three rounds, and they showed themselves in good light. Are you watching the MOL League?
Yes. Normally, I try to watch all the matches of the Slovakian teams during this season and the last season too. But for me, it was a surprise because now Sala won the three matches, and in the last match against Dunajská, they played a very good level. So this is the way for young players who are playing in Sala team. So I think, for example, Dunajská is a good team, but they need time to join the players and to reach that level. And they're saying that the Michalovce, totally new team with new players, they change a lot of players, and I think that they have more time to improve and to develop the level of the team.
Mm-hmm. Has anyone else made you interested? Someone who you count with the future?
Yes, I have a lot of players, young players, for example, players in
Stupava,
and players who are playing out in Hungary but in young teams. Mm-hmm. So I think that we need to control this player for the future because my target, my goal is to have more players in the atmosphere near of the national team to change and to take the best player in different moment because depends of the good condition to play with the national team.
When you started with the Slovak national team, you mentioned it that you want to focus on defense. What specifically would you like to change?
Yes, my intention is to improve the level, and I think that the first thing is to try to improve the level of the defense because if you defend in good level, you have more confidence, more trust to play better. So it's not easy because normally the players in Slovakia, in this part of Europe, try to defend totally different than that. That's my idea. So I tried step by step, change a little bit, some small things, and try to find better defense and try to put more problems to the attackers, more problems to good decisions. But I think that we need time to develop this. But I think that in the last matches against Spain and Hungary, we tried to practice, but we need to join better the players and try to find the best defense in the future. But I would like to practice a more active defense, not only wait for the attackers.
Mm-hmm. Is 1 week enough? What is the program going to look like?
Yeah, normally the coaches need more time to develop. But the problem with the national team, you have a reduced time, short time to work. But I think that during the last season, we have time to introduce the ideas. And during the next week, we have time to improve these ideas and try to arrange to try to get more communication and more combination between the players. So I think that this is a short time, but we need to take advantage of this time to develop because our target is step by step improve the level of the team.
What is the goal in games with Ukraine? What would you would make you happy to see from the players?
So these matches are important. Always the matches with the national team are important. But we are in the new season, and now the players know better me, and I know better the players. So I think that for the next days, for the next camps, I think that we have a chance to develop our skills and try to get the best of the players. So my target for this week is to try to have a lot of players playing during these matches, because my opinion is we have to play with more players, not only with say 7 or 8 players. We need to play with more players, and at the same time, I would like to give more chances for the young players to develop and to reach a good level. So my target, my clearly target for this camp, is to get a more participation of the players.
Mm-hmm. You used to be a goalkeeper. The nomination of Sonia Furgalakova made me personally very happy. She is one of the key players for the team in league matches in Shala. What type of goalkeeper is Sonia, and what can she possibly achieve?
Yes, Sonia, Victoria are very young players, very young goalkeepers. I think that the way of tennis is good, because step by step they are improving the level. In Vicky, the last championship, playing very good level in Slovenia, and Sonia started the season very good. In the last match against Dunaska, she played very good level. But normally we need patience with the player, but with the goalkeeper is more and more, because normally the goalkeepers need more experience and more confidence. So for this young player, we need to have patience and to support during these camps and during the future, because you know that the position of the goalkeeper is very important for a team, and we need to improve the level of this player. And Sonia now is a very good level, and I hope for the next improve more and more.
Mm-hmm. A trip to Montenegro is part of the next training phase, where we face great performing that from this country. What is the difference of the approach of each of these two teams, Ukraine and Montenegro? What would you like to try during these games?
Okay, Ukraine is a good team, but Montenegro is a top team. It's a very top team. So for us, it's very good to play with a tough team, because it's a chance to develop better and better our skills. So I prefer to play with these kind of teams, because in these matches we can practice our systems, and at the same time with a very good player. In this case, we will be able to look our better skills and our problems to develop our system. So I think that these matches will be very tough, but at the same time very, very good for develop and to take more information for the future.
Mm-hmm. What are the strongest and weakest points of our team?
Okay.
Right now, I think.
Okay, I think that my opinion is we have players with good skills, but in general, I think that we need to join the team and to play with a clear system to develop in defense, in attack, and fast break, and to return to defense. I think that we are able to practice during sometimes during some minutes during the match, but we need during the 60 minutes. No, we have with balance during 60 minutes. Mm-hmm. No up and downs a lot during the match. And for me, the more difficult for me is the problems in defense. For example, the problems to understand, try to work more in defense with active situations, and at the same time in attack, I would like to practice different possibilities to decide during situation in attack, not only one combination and try to shoot. If my opinion is better, try to develop the situation in attack and different possibilities to decide.
Mm-hmm. Who do you consider a natural leader in our team? Are there more of them?
I think that in this team we don't have a clearly leader, but I think for the future we have our players with not big experience, but with experience. Mm-hmm. as Vlada Vazhenkova or Ada Olejor, Aya. Mm-hmm. They are playing out of Slovakia, and I think that they can be leaders for the future. and I think that in the future they will play as a playmaker, as a center back, as center back. So I think that this player can be the leaders in the team. Mm-hmm.
In the first qualification phase, we face Latvia. What kind of opponent do you see them as?
I have some videos of these teams. I try to watch a little bit, mm-hmm. but I don't have very clear information at this moment. But I think that this is a team with a traditional handball with big players in defense, but no more so much active, and then good shooters in attack. So during the next dates, we will try to study better and to have more information about this team for the next month.
Mm-hmm. What do you think we need to be prepared for?
So, okay, I think that the first thing is to take advantage this week to try to join the team and to play as a team, no, with individual situation. I think that it's very important the mentality for these matches. Then after the Cano in Mihaloce, the players will have three weeks to play with the teams. So in this moment, I had to play a lot of matches because some of these clubs have to play the European Championships, mm-hmm. with the clubs. So for us, it will be important, no injuries the first, and then at the same time to get the best physical condition, and then during this next week, I will try to talk to the players about the important target, you know, of these matches against Latvia for the future.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to still train for with the team before this match?
Okay, I think that I would like to train a lot of during the morning and afternoon, but it's important the physical condition of the players, so we will try to take advantage of the time. We will train in the court in the arena, but at the same time we will train in the hotel and in the meetings to give information to know better the system and to develop during the matches. So this is now our target for these days. I think that the problem during this camp is we have a lot of meetings, a lot of trainings, and sometimes we give a lot of information. But my intention is to give clear information and know so much information and then confuse the system, confuse the information. So this is our target.
Yes, Jorge, thank you very much and good luck.
It's very important. The luck is always important.
Vám ďakujeme samozrejme za pozornosť. To bol reprezentačný kormidelník ženského výberu Slovenska, španielský odborník Jorge Duenes. No a ja len pripomínam, že od nedele nás čaká zraz v Michalovciach, kde sa budú naše dievčatá pripravovať vlastne prvý zraz v novej sezóne. Na záver tohto zrazu budú na programe dva zápasy s Ukrajinou, jeden v piatok, jeden v sobotu. Oba si budete môcť pozrieť naživo prostredníctvom Šport TV kanálu. No a čo ešte takého by sme mali povedať? No a všetko podstatné samozrejme vám budú kolegovia prinášať aj z Michaloviec na našej webovej stránke, prípadne na sociálnych sieťach. Ďakujeme za pozornosť a majte sa krásne.